this water coming out of this mine has got a lot of metals that are dissolved in the water because the water has coursed through all the old rocks that are in the mine that were left behind that contain metals. Where this water comes from is an open stope that's about 600 vertical feet above here. And so the plan is to go up there and plug that stope so that water can't get into it. This is a vein that was mined from below, and the vein was about varying in width anywhere from maybe 10 feet wide to about 60 foot wide, and they came up 600 vertical, almost 700 vertical feet, and came right to the surface and left this large opening, which all the snow avalanches would come down here and get caught into the mine workings. It filled up with ice. We couldn't even enter the upper part of the workings because it was filled with ice. We're only part way up the mountain. This mountain goes up about 2,500 vertical feet. And that's where the avalanches would start, and they'd come barreling down this whole area. Once the stope was filled up with snow, then the excess would run on down the valley.
The open stopes are in direct path of avalanches. In the spring, two streams flow directly into the ice-packed stopes. This compounds the process of adding dissolved metals into the stream bed.
The water was able to penetrate along the sides of the rock walls and get into the mine workings right at the bottom level. And thus, dissolve the metals out of the ore that was left behind.
The estimated cost to run a water treatment plant downstream might be $1 million a year, every year, forever. The cost for this project is approximately $600,000 one time. The goal is to prevent residual metals inside the Pride of the West mine from entering the stream bed forever. Another important benefit of covering these large openings at abandoned mines is the increased safety of backcountry skiers, hikers, and climbers. The crew had to chisel the edges of the openings to remove any loose rock and to drill the slots for the steel crossbeams, which were brought in by helicopter at 11,000 feet. It is very difficult to fly a helicopter at this altitude, especially when carrying heavy steel. The helicopter would come up the hill with one steel beam at a time. The crew was standing by, ready to guide the beams into place. Again, the helicopter flew up to the site, this time with heavy loads of cement. The crew was able to seal the steel beams into place. Steel decking was laid onto the cross beams. The crew welded the steel plates together, then laid a protective coating on the entire surface.
Oh,